Welcome to the first ever edition of Hono Afterburn. I'm your host, Brick9mm. Our first match of the night, we'll see Midnight Jones take on Ross Cromley. It's boxer versus boxer in the explosive opening match for this first ever episode of Hono Afterburn. Now, Cromley has years of experience under his belt, whereas Midnight Jones seems to be relatively new to the game. Of course, in the end, it all comes down to the technique, but more experience means the more refined technique. There's a lot of angles to approach a boxing match. It's not mere punching. It's skill, war, mind games, as we will see here tonight. Neither man seems to have taken the lead yet. Of course, when you have two boxers in the ring, it won't take long for the match to be decided. Cromley seems to be infinitely more skilled on the defensive end, as he already has knocked down Midnight Jones for a second time. Not long enough to trigger a TKO count, but it matters all the same. Cromley seems to have the clear advantage at this point. But if Midnight Jones can sneak in more strikes like he did just there and just there, he could get the leg up on Ross Cromley. They're exchanging blows. This could be a valuable opportunity for Midnight Jones to go get acquainted with the mat. He's down, but he's not out of the fight yet. Knockout punch. Falls a little short of the mark, however. The seconds tick down of round one. Cromley seems to be in the firm lead, but Midnight Jones is trying his hardest to make the comeback. And he just might. Start of the second round. Cromley with the knockout punch. Jones isn't looking too good. As he takes his first fall. Jones gets up at the five count. Cromley continues to pound away at Midnight Jones. But Jones is still showing his fighting spirit. Cromley shuts down that spirit with a devastating barrage of strikes. However, Midnight Jones gets up at the four count and counters with a barrage of strikes of his own. And another. Cromley takes his first fall, however, for Midnight Jones, his next fall is his last. Jones gets up in the nick of time. Uppercut. Discus punch. He's not out yet. Barely avoids that rolling elbow. Another series of uppercuts from Midnight Jones. Cromley with the rolling elbow, knocking Midnight Jones out. Midnight Jones had a very impressive showing for a newcomer, but in the end, Cromley has won this match. Welcome back to Hono Afterburn. Here we have a very interesting matchup as Anton Mikhailov faces Bruce Lee. It's a very interesting clash of styles as Bruce Lee is a karateka. Anton Mikhailov is a wrestler. Both styles focus on grappling, whereas the Karateka favors quick strikes. Even though both are trained in grappling, the wrestler owns grappling. They focus so much on the mat that you could call them masters of the mat. Whereas the Karateka, the skill level of their mat work depends on the fighter, and Bruce Lee is a fan of flashy kicks. However, he's got a few holds up his sleeve, as we just saw with that cross arm breaker. Of course, if you put them both on the mat, Anton Mikhailov is the clear winner, but Bruce catches Anton in another cross arm breaker, but Anton catches Bruce in the leg lock, beginning to work on those legs of Bruce Lee. If he can take out Bruce Lee's legs, Bruce does not stand a chance. Of course, at the same time, Anton is working on Bruce Lee's arms as well. He is just systematically destroying Bruce limb by limb. Of course, Bruce still has the leg up. Anton with the arm lock, looking to change that. Fierce strike rush by Bruce Lee. Bruce Lee has Anton down the mat. Anton, Bruce Lee in the ankle lock. Bruce Lee going down on the mat again. This is a very bad idea for Bruce Lee. He should remember his focus should be the kicks, which Anton keeps stealing those kicks away from him as he continues to work on those legs of Bruce Lee. This has been an exciting first round, as both men have made their approaches clear. Anton snaps Bruce Lee's arm. This match was over before it even begun for Bruce Lee.
Final battle, battle!
Welcome back to Hono Afterburn, as we have a bit of an unusual matchup. Nine Stein, the kickboxer, versus the wrestler, Todd Mitchell, inventor of the speed run. Now, Nine Stein is a very skilled striker, but Mitchell is deadly on the mat. This clash of styles is what makes striker versus grappler matches so exciting, because Nine Stein could end this match at any moment with his kicks. And the wrestler is a slow burn, arm lock, wear down. Over the course of a match, the wrestler can utterly decimate every single last body part, limb by limb. The fighter taken down, but the kickboxer, fast strikes, immediate damage. They're being a little defensive here. Who wouldn't be? It's when you're fighting a mat work guy like that, you have to avoid, because while the kickboxer's kicks could end the match immediately, getting down on that mat with a skilled wrestler could end the match just as quickly. Stein responding with quick strike combination. He's not leaving any openings for Todd Mitchell to get any attacks through, as he responds with a devastating strike rush. He catches Todd Mitchell. Todd Mitchell, neck lock. Both men have to be on the defensive here. Nine Stein with a fast strike rush and the penalty kick. The end of round one fast approaching. With another strike rush, Nine Stein cements himself as the clear winner of round one, but round two is the difference maker. He catches Todd Mitchell. He is beginning to adapt to Todd Mitchell's wrestling style. Even if you aren't formally trained in an environment like Honoo Pro, you just have to adapt to survive as Todd Mitchell with the belly-to-back suplex. Will those suplexes? Will no amount of suplexes can stop a ferocious rush like that, followed by the penalty kick. But Mitchell is not staying down. Mitchell is on his feet. But Nine Stein with another deadly rush.
One, two,
Mitchell with the first fall. He gets up at the three count. Mitchell with the ground headlock. Stein has the clear advantage at this point. I don't know if Todd Mitchell can recover from all of this damage, and another penalty kick. Wakigatame. Stein with another deadly barrage of strikes. That is Todd Mitchell's second fall of the round. Even if he gets up now, he got up at the 9 count. Wakigatame, even though he just got up at the 9 count, his next fall will be his last. And it could be right here as Nine Stein is a monster. Utterly destroying the wrestler Todd Mitchell, who speed ran his way to certain death in the second round. It is now time for our main event as Lucas Von Hahn, the hybrid fighter, makes his debut against Ricky Quick, the skilled amateur wrestler. He may be small, but don't let that deceive you. That size of his gives him the agility he needs to get the leg up on similar mat work technician. Like so, cross arm breaker for merely a second. Lucas is a better all-around fighter in every respect, but Ricky Quick has the mat settled with the rolling shoulder hold. In this first ever Honoo Afterburn main event, will Ricky Quick defeat the German Lucas Von Hahn with the rolling shoulder arm breaker? Or will Lucas and his knowledge of holds, in addition to his striking prowess, will Lucas defeat Ricky Quick? It's anybody's guess as Lucas locks in another flying cross arm breaker. He has the clear advantage here as far as striking goes, as far as submission hold variety goes. But Ricky Quick has that agility. Then again, Lucas's agility is not to be underestimated either. As he counters into another arm lock. With every single hold, Lucas comes closer and closer to destroying Ricky Quick. But Ricky Quick has many tricks up his sleeve. We can't count him out just yet. They're being a little more defensive now as Ricky gets Lucas on the mat for a counter. Lucas working again on that leg of Ricky Quick as of the seconds tick down. Lucas is the clear winner of this first round, but Ricky Quick is not out of the fight yet. Ricky Quick again caught in that cross arm breaker. The damage should be taking its toll any second now. Spinning leg lock. Lucas caught in the back roll necklock, but not long enough for it to count. Lucas destroying the ankles. Ricky counters back with an ankle hold of his own. Palm strike rush. Lucas is shooting to kill. Lucas down on the mat. Ricky quick behind Lucas. Caught in the leg lock once again. Ricky Quick is still on his feet, but for how long? Ankle lock. Another. Both of these men are formidable fighters as Lucas locks in the one true ankle lock. Quick again. The speed of these men is unbelievable. Orienteering with napalm death. His ankles completely and utterly destroyed. How is Ricky Quick holding out? Will Ricky Quick make it to the third round? This durability is almost inhuman. Lucas Von Hahn is just playing with him at this point, but can Ricky Quick make the comeback? I don't think he can. This ankle lock should spell his doom, but no! Ricky Quick is not out of the fight yet. Ricky Quick. This has to be it. This... No! Ricky Quick is still in the fight! How has Ricky Quick endured this long? He catches Lucas Von Hahn in another ankle lock. Another! This is insanity. This is Hono'o Pro Wrestling. Sprawling leg lock. This has to be it. This has to be it. How is Ricky still standing? How has Ricky endured this assault by Lucas Von Hahn? Lucas, ankle lock, it's over! Ricky Quick demonstrated superhuman endurance there with a career-defining performance, a star-making performance, but Lucas Von Hahn decimated him with the ankle lock. Thank you for watching the first ever episode of Hono Afterburn. Good night.